Hey, everybody.
Welcome back to Dark Souls.
Welcome to Dark Souls.
And as you can read the title, unless you're illiterate, welcome to the finale of the Dog Pound and the finale of this channel, really, I guess. Unless I make something tomorrow, there's just like a little wrap up deal. But as far as co-op and our normal stuff goes, this is it. Unfortunately, couldn't get Logan in, so it's just Ashton and I.
Yes.
We'll be taking it about an hour or so retrospect of the channel, talking about what's, you know, our decision behind this and all that again, for those that may not have heard. And it was basically, we both had the same idea at the same time, that the only game to really end the channel off of is Dark Souls. I mean, there's really nothing else.
You can't show me a better game that depicts this channel at this point than Dank Meme 7.
And, you know, we ended off on the Ring
Still
City as our final playthrough. I did. Apologies if my mic volume's all over the place this episode too, because I'm having to hold it because my equipment's just breaking down. So
I'm getting raped.
So Ash is just playing with his lovely character Pot Roast from a
one night we decided to try and drink and play Dark Souls. It didn't work out because I'm pretty sure we killed the gargoyles, otherwise we wouldn't have this tail.
Unless you just cut it off, but you got it upgraded, so you had souls to upgrade at some point.
I'm assuming we killed them.
Yeah,
I feel like I need to go check.
Yeah, good God.
No, I think we did.
Do we need to go to Blighttown now?
Let's just check and see if we have the soul.
Yeah. That would be the thing to do.
We do not have the soul.
We wouldn't have
spent
it.
No, you killed him, remember? I'm pretty sure you killed him.
I don't remember.
I could have swore you did it because we really tried really hard and you finally did it.
I don't remember. Yeah, there was a lot of schnapps and bad whiskey involved
that
night,
really
so I don't remember.
Bad.
I don't really remember.
My brother said there's a way. I was watching him the other day, and there's a way to literally jump down here and avoid doing anything important.
That didn't surprise me. He is becoming a god at this game.
Yeah, quite simply. Let's see. What way did he
do? So I've explained our whole situation like three different times. You want to tell the audience what's going on?
Okay, so like me and Ryan are becoming real adults now, I guess. And I'm in law school. I'll be starting my second year next year. I'm in my first year. I'm almost finished. And Ryan's, like, moving and stuff because he has,
about
like, a career.
About 300 miles away?
About 300 miles away. So we decided that as we have grown as adults, I mean, we think we're adults. We're probably not adults. But as we believe to
fake grown, it till you make it.
Fake it till you make it, fam. But as we believe to see him grow as adults, we think that we should probably start a new channel so we can rebrand ourselves into stuff we actually like doing. Because we kind of became a Dark Souls channel, and that was it. Which is cool and all, but, like, Logan's gone. It's just me and Ryan, basically. It's mostly Ryan, because I'm always busy as hell, and I don't have internet at my house.
And I'm the principal editor.
Yeah.
And doing three times a week at minimum, and it's basically been four times a week with the podcast and stuff, with Off the Leash and Dog Pound. I can't do it anymore. I just can't.
It's hard.
It's not, I mean, I can, the time itself that we're doing this and making content, I love it.
But everything in between
sucks. But editing
mouth.
Let's plays that is just me, I've grown to detest it. It's such a grind, and like I really enjoy, you know, when we do stuff and when Ash, you know, Ash and Logan and me were all together.
Oh, that was the best of times.
Yeah, I mean, I could, you know, it was like rewatching it as I was editing it, and I was reliving that experience, and it was fun. But just redoing my own stuff, God, I can see how YouTubers get so burnt out. So.
Oh, it seems like it's just easy, honestly. Like, I don't see how people do it over and over and over again. It just doesn't
seem
practical.
So, number one, I didn't want that to carry over into hating making content in general. But also, we wanted to do music stuff. And, you know, I tried it a couple times on this channel, but it was pretty obvious that we made pretty much an entirely gaming-oriented audience, and it wasn't going to fly.
Yeah, so we kind of had to migrate.
Yeah, and on the new channel we started, which you can watch a video on this channel from a few weeks ago called An End of a Journey, if you want to check it out and see what it's all about. But we're already seeing better growth, better reception by far. Obviously because, you know, I've learned some things doing YouTube for, you know, 2.5 years. And dead.
Oh, well, that didn't work.
That's good. You can always bow them, I guess.
Yeah, but we decided to not do the Drake Sword this time around.
Could be.
Oh,
like
no,
we
got all the way to Darker Garden, didn't we? Because I remember, like, trying to fight the shitheads with this axe, and it wasn't doing a damn thing.
I guess we did.
It was
I don't
not
remember.
Doing well.
I don't remember.
I don't know what we're trying to do. We're trying to base cannon.
Oh, that's what it is. So that's generally the whole thinking behind, you know, we don't want to have so much incriminating evidence. It's kind of like Devin Townsend's situation with Strapping Young Lad, I guess. We're going to see him very soon.
We just don't want to have this on
and
our
yeah,
record,
I mean,
basically.
He feels different about, you know, he's a different person since he did Strapping Young Lad. He doesn't want that to hold him back or whatever, and it's kind of the same thing with this channel. So I'm downloading stuff as we speak as a physical backup. I'm going to leave a lot of stuff up, but I'm also going to be unlisting a lot of stuff. And because it's Logan's personal channel, you know, it's not like we can just turn on a head and be like, all right, we're going to rebrand ourselves.
No, this Logan owns pretty much everything about
this. Yeah, so the one time we did get money, it came to him. So I don't want that to be an issue when we're hundreds of miles away and all that. So that's the general thinking behind it. And we, you know, to be able to do the quality of gaming videos that we want to do is just not going to happen very often over, you know, when we're so far apart. So that's why. That's what's going on.
So, Dark Souls.
So that's why we're playing this. And it's not the 30 FPS stretch 4x3 shit version on Xbox 360. It's the slightly less
shit version
on PC. But I got some
some
graphical stuff, like the HUD is prettier. I got the Xbox One button.
I was about to say, like, the HUD looks a little bit better this time around.
Yeah, made it look a little bit more like Scholar for Sin. But yeah, there's a few recent things I think we wanted to talk about here, but a lot of this is going to be reminiscing and
on the good old days.
You know, a final recap of the channel.
The fact of me and Ryan were much younger people then.
Yeah.
2 years ago doesn't seem like that long of a time, but it totally is. My life wasn't nearly as stressful 2 years ago. Ah, you son of a bitch.
Yeah, time has become just my worst enemy.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't know whether, like, I think back to high school, and it's like, you know, I had a decent amount of homework then, still.
But now it just feels like I have less time on my hands.
Yeah, but I did get a lot of done, you know, stuff done on the bus on the way home, if I did have it. But I didn't have, I guess, the drive to want to accomplish as much, because, like, I'm working on 4 albums right now. I've got all these plans for the new channel. Moving, new job, it's just like, I need an extra 24 hours in the day to
and
get everything
just
done.
Not there.
It's just not going to happen. So it's kind of a funny dynamic since then. But as far as news and stuff goes, there's a couple things we want to talk about. First of all, I was telling Ashton on the way to go get pizza about the stupid move that NVIDIA just pulled. So AMD has been in the news largely because of Ryzen, Ryzen 7, Ryzen 5. Ryzen 5 is doing really well for the price. NVIDIA came out with the 1080 Ti not too long ago. We talked about that on Dog Pound. But the most recent thing is a new Titan. New, not so new, old Titan card. So to get the full story of how stupid this is, we'll have to go back to March 2015. So well over 2 years ago. So in March that year, they announced, Jen did on stage, I think it was I guess the same, was it GDC or wherever, Computex, whatever that is, that they announced the 1080 Ti this year. Jen announced the Titan X, a Maxwell card that was more or less the full-fledged version of, you know, the Maxwell architecture.
Yes.
And 12 gigs of VRAM, DDR5, just, you know, monster of a card for the time. Then the 980 Ti came out a few months later for $350 less, basically same performance, half the VRAM, same story with the 780 Ti and original Titan, you know, the generation before, blah, blah, blah. Okay. Then August 2016, the Titan X comes out again, but this time it's Pascal. And came out really soon after the 1080, which was a little unusual, but to avoid confusion, because NVIDIA's marketing was so stupid, and calling it the Titan X again. This time, the NVIDIA Titan X, not the GeForce Titan X, though, even though it was still a gaming card and had GeForce GTX written on the side of it, people started calling it the Titan XP, obviously reference to Windows XP and, you know, P meaning Pascal. So everyone was like, you know, stupid name, but we're on board. We know what the Titan XP is. Well, about a week ago.
About a week ago.
So NVIDIA releases the Titan XP. I wish I was kidding. Capital X, lowercase p.
Baby p.
12 gigs of VRAM. Faster VRAM of GDDR5X. A few more CUDA cores. Also $1,200. Same thing with the previous Titan X. Not the Titan X original. Titan X Pascal. But not the Titan X little p, big p. And this, of course, is right off the heels of the GTX 1080 Ti being released at $700, also being slightly faster than the middle Titan X. This is so awful to talk about. So, yeah, rightfully so, there's plenty of original Titan owners. You know, they were kind of expecting, yeah, we're going to get a 1080 Ti eventually. That's what happens every generation. But, you know, paying for it now, whatever, I want the best. But now, there's literally no reason to own the old one, so...
Literally, not a single shred of why the fuck? Nope.
So, what's going on, NVIDIA? Are you scared of Vega that bad? Like, I don't think you're going to reach performance that way, but...
They need the pizza, please.
Who else does that stupid kind of naming scheme where they'll name something the same thing 10 times a row? Oh,
fuck. You got me. There's something.
Nintendo's not good for it. The no, new 3DS, not. The whatever, new 3DS XL, all that shit. Razer's bad about it. There's like the Razer Fall 2016 blade versus the original Razer blade. But there's something else I'm thinking of that their name scheme is asinine. Well, Xbox's isn't much better at this rate. Xbox 360, Xbox One, Xbox One S, Xbox Scorpio, whatever that's called. I don't know if it's actually going to be called the Scorpio.
Scorponok!
Supposedly, the Scorpio is going to be like a GTX 1070-ish GPU, but like an 8-core, 16-core CPU with like 2.3 gigahertz.
Fly.
I don't give a shit. Hopefully, I can play Halo 6 on my PC when it comes out. That's
Halo 85.
Be my goal.
Master Chief is now in a wheelchair and commanding the whole UNSC.
But yeah, names. Names are hard for companies.
Names are hard, bro. Check my SoundCloud, bro. But they really are hard, like difficult for some reason. I don't understand why still.
Just use numbers. Like, I get that there's buzzword marketing and shit, but it cannot be beneficial to name something the same thing.
500 times.
The exact same thing. It's not like, you know, cars where you're like, well, there's a Dodge 1500 and there's a Dodge 1500, but there's a 2005, 2006, 2007.
They got years at least. They could be like the GTX 980 2016.
Yeah.
Make it a little like decisive, like, okay, that's what I just bought.
But I honestly think they want to confuse people, and it's just...
To get people to buy shit.
Yeah, the wrong thing. It's just fucking infuriating.
Over and over again.
So yeah, that's... I've yet to figure that one out. I hope they get a social backlash over that. Won't be as bad as the United thing. I saw a really fucking... good meme on that one. Where is it?
Was it a prequel meme? Carry out order 66.
Oh, that's what it was. United Airlines removed customers from overbooked flight 3411, and it's the opening scene to that Modern Warfare 2 airport mission where you just mow down people.
Oh, so it's the senator. That's, execute order 66.
That one,
yes, sir. Yeah,
that one's pretty good, too. There's also one where there's
my face?
United plane that's wearing a hat that says, please be patient, I have autism. That one's okay. Yeah. This is, man, we're making this episode age gracefully.
What a time to be alive. Mm-hmm. What a time.
What a game to be making a PC that's 80 times more powerful than it needs to be running this.
Oh, yeah, we could probably run this on a literal toaster at this point.
Yeah, I could probably downclock it to like a 10th and we'd still be running at 60. But that's all good. What would you buy, honestly, when you get a Nintendo Switch? I've been enjoying mine very much here recently.
Oh, what's happening?
I beat Spectre Knight on the plane. That was fun.
Spectre Knight fun?
Oh, yeah. It was. He controls so... It's so fun. Playing Plague Knight right now, and it's a little harder, not as fun to me, but I'm definitely going to play it because I want to do everything to get out of that game. Very good value for $25. Insane value. But if they came out with Dark Souls 1, 2, and 3 for Switch...
I'd play the piss out
of
that.
Absolutely, me too.
I mean, mobile Dark Souls sounds fun as hell.
I don't care if it's... Just to be mobile, 30 really. FPS. Mobile would do it. Especially if you can somehow import character saves, but I wouldn't even do that. It'd be pretty sweet.
For some reason, when Ty was playing this, Sigwitter was already dead. Don't know why.
The first time you go there?
Yeah, he was just dead. Strange. Like, his stuff was there. He's like, I didn't kill him, but he's dead.
That's fair. Maybe one of the snake people spawned outside or something. Ooh.
Think about Katarina.
Same voice actor, right? Season
yeah.
Three.
Yeah, they just did better voice acting.
Still closed.
Yeah, good old Sigward. But yeah, I like the second Sigward better. Or Sigmire. I like Sigward.
I like all
better.
The NPCs in three.
I just like Sigward in the second one because you get the cool NPC mission with Yorm.
Yeah, that whole backstory.
Like, hey,
pretty,
bro, fam.
It's pretty unusual to do a different cutscene for a boss. That was pretty neat. But oh, Andre. There was something else halfway recent besides PC stuff, seems like. We're going to a concert soon. You can check out the other channel for some type of vlog on that. Hopefully, if we get lucky, it might turn out to be something really, really cool.
We're up for all night for good fun. We're up all night to get lucky. Here we go.
We could get a hotel room and just get destroyed afterwards if we want, because
this is very true.
It's a Sunday. We don't have school. It's not like we got to drive
I'm
back.
I'm super done at that
Meshuggah.
Point.
Yeah, me too. I have to move either
I'm
day
doing
or two
no
after,
damage to him.
Run!
Yeah, this does negative damage. I remember when I played this the first time, I had a fucking sorcerer / pyromancy. I had, like, sorcery and, like, pyromancy as a backup for range stuff just to have it.
It's
well, this fucking sucks.
So, for the channel, top one or top three series or games we've played.
Top three series? I mean, yep. My favorite series, I guess, to start was when we initially did, like, real life stuff with Logan, like Bean Boozled
yeah.
and the baby food thing. That was fun. Like, just to record
yeah.
was fun. Like, it was painful.
Oh, yeah.
It sucked, but it was funner than hell. I
yep.
did most
of those were fantastic. There's a couple lost vlogs, too, that never made it. One where we went to, the Nudgening.
Oh, God.
No, when we went to the movies. And we were like the only people in there. And there was basically this sex couch in the middle of the discount movies.
It was great.
It was.
We went and saw Fury.
Yeah, it was.
With Brad Pitt.
Very, and Shia LaBeouf.
Hey, baby.
He will nut inside us.
He will nut inside us. Ah, will you shut the fuck up?
Whee! Fantastic video.
All right, this is not going well.
Yeah, that one was a lot of fun. I need the live action.
Yeah, the real time stuff. Like, all right, I need to back up. I cannot get fucking range on this motherfucker.
Me, as far as going back and watching stuff, I love the Evil Within so
oh,
much.
Oh God,
that
was
one was
so
one of my favorites.
Bad.
Some of the moments in Dark Souls still make me borderline piss my pants.
Dark Souls just
with Logan was just amazing.
This way to the witch.
Yeah, I that one is one of my all time things we've ever put
recorded
on the channel.
Period.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, Idar was fucking amazing.
Idar
was
amazing.
That was what I'm.
Yep. Having four of us was so chaotic.
And having Devin's like one cameo in a series.
Yep.
Was nice.
The when it cut to the Kinect camera, that was some good stuff.
Yeah, there's plenty of great stuff there. We had that was pretty fucking good.
Yep.
I think Idar was a good one. Trial by Fire with Logan, anything.
Anything he did. If I had to pick a single video, because I love Dark Souls as a series, but the Call of Duty 4 Mile High Club.
Oh you
my
did
God.
That real early on, didn't you?
Yeah.
That was like before I really got on.
Yeah, that was March, probably, of 2015,
that was
I
before
guess.
I really got to, like,
yeah.
I mean, I got on, but I wasn't, like, full
yeah,
on
regular,
yet.
Yeah.
I was, God. Like, a guest in yeah. the first, like, I remember being a guest originally
yep.
in videos. We act like we're celebrities, like, I'm a fucking guest, but, like, literally, I was a guest with their original stuff. I think it was the first you tried by fires with Logan? I was still a guest?
Your first stuff was, I don't know that it's the first thing that came out, but your first videos we recorded was The Evil Within.
Oh, that was so bad. Was it me or Logan playing?
Logan was initially, then you finally got him through the last part, and I was like, yep,
that's
all
it.
We're
never doing this again. That was a bad game. The really bad DLC.
No, The Walking Dead was a bad game.
Oh, that...
I can't believe
that's
we
a
got,
series that I'll be never, ever, ever forget.
I can't believe we got through that.
This game was so bad. Like, literally, that game was so fucking bad. The graphics were shit because they rendered old dickhead really well.
and everybody else
looked like claymation.
Yeah, it was like, we're going to waste all of our graphical budget on Norman Reedus, and that's it. That's all we can afford.
Merle had like a weird Muppet mouth.
Yep.
And the end of that game was just stupid.
In a helicopter, we're safe.
And then we like just mow down like New Orleans Saints football stadium full of zombies.
Pretty fantastic. Yeah, those were good. I really enjoyed doing all the one-off crazy shit I did. I'm most proud of, as far as like comedic value stuff, the Call of Duty parodies I did.
Oh,
because they got super pissed off.
You're like,
oh,
Call of Duty
so many
7.
Salty fucking people. It made me the Infinite Warfare sneak peek video that I did, where I just played Call of Duty 4 modded, was some of the
people were the most upset.
That had the biggest backlash, but the people that enjoyed it, I feel like fucking loved it. So I really liked that one.
I thought it was a quality video.
I don't know. I wasn't even drinking or anything.
No,
I was just like,
you were like, hey, go watch this. I put some time into it.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm just feeling salty over this shit. So I'm just gonna be an idiot, and that's what I did.
Totally worth it because that was a funny ass video. Just mostly because people were so
upset.
Oh,
they were so serious too. I'm like, guys, do you really think someone with like less than 1,000 subs is gonna get
the
sneak peek to the game?
Yeah.
Are you gullible? So that was fantastic. The some of the FPS Fridays, too, I really loved. The Call of Duty 4 one, where I said Call of Duty 4 remastered for free, because that's what it was PC. You got everything for free. And people were salty over that, too. But
people are salty over everything at this point, and it's amazing.
Yep. There's a couple other really ridiculous ones I did. But
just the fun stuff here and there.
Yeah. Oh, the Fallout 4, the Deathclaw.
Oh, my little Deathclaw.
Yeah, my little Deathclaw. That one was fun. I remember reading that like 2 weeks after the game came out. I was like, I had no idea. I've got
to
go home.
I need to do this right now.
And I did, and it was so much fun. Random Battlefield 4 stuff. Feeding the pig.
Feeding the pig was great.
I enjoyed that a lot. That's when I first was like, you know what? I'm gonna use editing as a comedic effect, not just...
One of my favorite things I ever did that never made it to the channel because the recording didn't fucking work was I bought Woodle Tree Adventure, and I recorded that for 3 hours because it was that fucking hard of a platformer. I'm not even kidding. I bought it for like 80 cents. I'm like, I have extra money. I'm gonna buy this stupid fucking game. And I was just screaming fucking Woodle for a solid like 2 hours in my room. And I was like, alright, time to edit. It's not there. It's gone.
Hey, and it's gone.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of how many failed or technical recordings I've had. I'm already up to like two on the new channel. Because one time I had a frequency issue with the mic. So it was like my sampling rate was 44,100 or whatever. And it was supposed to be 48,000. So it recorded it like...
give it a ball. I remember finishing Dead Space 2. That was an awful game.
Don't you wish we'd have done 3? The microtransaction...
Did I just get hurt?
What was that? Oh, nice.
What the fucking ass?
They followed you all the way up here. This is not the series where you just run away.
This is not the... These are not the souls you're looking for. Alright. Wow, I got a Titanite from that guy. We already killed the Channeler up here, so let's go fight Captain Assholes here. And I know no matter how hard you fucking kill what's-his-name, it doesn't do shit.
Yeah, I'm not... The more I'm thinking about it, I don't remember what the hell we did on this character. Because the more I think about it, the more I'm thinking about my...
I don't know what we did.
New Game Plus character, not this one, so...
I can't remember... I mean, we have the tail.
But so there's no soul, so...
Did we crush it?
I feel like
we might have crushed it and used it to level up.
Maybe, because it was like, what the fuck else you want to do with Gargoyle
Soul? Exactly, because the Gargoyle Soul gives you what? I can't fucking remember.
Me either. Something shit, obviously.
Even if you kill Lortric here, he's still...
Still a dick.
Yeah, the fog wall's not there. So I guess we did kill the Gargoyles.
It's news to me.
Just to say how much we lack in knowledge of what we played that night...
It's been a while.
Well, we played the Dark Souls game. We just took shot to shot to shot to shot to shot.
It needs to be... I mean, I guess that's a good game for amateurs, but we didn't die nearly enough.
No, we did not.
Gotta amend those rules. Anytime you take damage.
Oh.
Anytime you use Estus. I don't know.
Hi, Blake. Hello. Just a little side note. My brother played Dark Souls 3 through again.
Mm-hmm.
Beat the whole Dark Souls 3 campaign in 9 hours. And then is on our way through Lord and Lothric 2 in New Game Plus.
Jesus.
He's Shomer level bullshit. Oh, yeah, Blake's here. Yeah.
Talking about favorite videos.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Just trying to think of stuff. Where do we need to go? I need to go to the depths.
The baby food challenge.
That's what I talked about. Yeah. I was like, that's one of my favorites, just because, God, it was so gross. And some of them really weren't that bad.
Some of them were downright great, but what was that fucking chunky shit that was just...
Oh, God. It was like, what
was
it?
That taste still haunts my dreams.
I can't remember what it is, but it was disgusting.
And spoon-fed, it might have not been so bad, but out of a shot glass, God. It was like...
I remember you, like, shoot it out of the little baby
it was like,
pouches.
Yeah, peas.
Into a shot glass.
Peas and carrots and something else. I don't remember, but it
burnt
was...
Burnt asshole.
Oh, God. Yeah, that was not our... The jelly beans were... Fucking terrible.
Oh, Bean Boozled was rough.
I don't know what poor guy has to stand there and be like, no, that's not vomity enough.
R.I.P. Never forget.
We need more acid.
I know what vomit tastes like, and that's not nearly close enough.
Rotten eggs? Nope. More sulfur.
That one smelled like shit, though. Like, in my mouth,
that
I
one
could
was
smell it.
Literally, like, vomit-inducing. That was that was like tricking your body into you have something rotten in your mouth. Get it out. It amazing. It was pretty awful.
It was closed. Still closed. Where the fuck am I
really love the Insurgency series where you found Uncle Diddy's son on the wall. That was pretty good.
Oh, Candigal!
That was
the first time we played... Well, we played Insurgency with Logan a few times because that's one of the few games he could fucking play.
Yeah, and run.
And run.
My Gmod series with him was pretty fucking outstanding, too.
Well, I remember the night we and you did a dog pound with Gmod, and I had none of the fucking textures.
Yeah.
It was all purple and just said void. Oh, it hurt my eyes
Logan,
so bad.
Go buy CS Source if you're going to buy his Counter-Strike. All right, buy his Counter-Strike, go.
He literally bought CS. No, it was he needed this Counter-Strike Source
textures.
Skins, and he bought the game to get the textures.
Yeah, I was like, dude, you can download the...
So he owns CS Source.
And go.
Oh, no, I do, too. I got it in a bundle.
Yeah,
Logan bought it because he... I don't know. I don't know why I bought it.
Yeah.
How do I...
He bought one, like, you each had, like, one crate. We did an unboxing in one night.
Let's do the unboxing. We had like 50 seconds worth of material.
That was
when we had the massive LAN party at your house with the tables. And the next day we went to what was it, Jungle Gyms and all that.
Yep.
Bought the shit cigars and Logan bought his giant.
Yeah, and of course the 50 cent cigar tasted the best out of all of them. I finished that one. Well, all but like a tenth of it. I threw the rest out on New Year's because I was like, I'm tired of looking at this fucking thing. And Black and Mild still better.
I'm just thinking about how awful it'd be if they could tell like how much liquor, like alcohol, you consume.
Oh, we'd
in
all
past
be
month.
every college student would be so fucked. If they want to really be dicks, they can do that with your hair. I'm pretty sure
they can.
Yeah, they can do it with nicotine, 100% sure. But alcohol is like it's not as accurate.
Dad said they can because they do it Toyota.
Yeah,
through your hair.
It doesn't stick around nearly as long as nicotine or.
But if
or
you
THC.
Did the night before,
oh yeah,
it's
if
there.
You come in the night before, you're boned. That's why. Yeah, they do that shit for if you wreck a forklift or something like that. There's about a 6 month gap that I don't even remember what we did for the channel in the least.
Which gap was this?
Summer gap.
Didn't mean to do this.
Basically, I don't remember at all.
Oh God, which summer was it?
Like after I completed Scholar of the First Sin.
Oh God, what did we do that summer? That's when we did my build.
Yeah, I played some Stalker. I remember that. I have no idea other than that.
I really don't.
We did some random nostalgia boxes, Logan and I. Remember that? We played some shit on like the original Xbox. And other than that, I just couldn't tell you a damn thing.
I've only been running around the Undead Burg for like...
And this is what you do in early Dark Souls to level up. I was about to say. They're either behind you or they're about to fall off. Oh, poison. The best. Up, 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 and... Yep. Oh.
And I'm stranded, caught in the bonfire.
Oh. Ow. Pooped him.
That was I remember, didn't you and Logan play Advanced Warfare on the 360?
Oh, God.
And it looked like
we did that one morning. I remember doing that.
Oh, God. And every time you were about to win the 360, you disconnect from the internet.
Yes! We had three matches in a row!
It's older than fucking dirt and the ports going bad.
Literally, me and Logan would have won, like, three matches in a row. Yeah. But
it just kept disconnecting.
How do you get down to the fucking, like,
I know it wasn't my connection, because the one was fine. That was so
but
funny.
I remember, yeah, because Logan, we played something that night, though, because Logan brought a bunch of games over for some fucking reason.
Yeah, he brought that's when we, like, fucking God Walking Dead. I cannot believe we finished that piece of shit.
You guys played all through the Telltale?
No, I wish.
We played through...
I was about to say, I don't remember that.
No, we played through the goddamn one where you play as Norman Reedus. And it's the worst piece of shit ever made.
Yeah, and Merle's a Muppet.
I don't even remember.
Forgot that existed.
Yeah.
You should.
Yeah, it's...
That was a fun-ass game.
It is 2 out of 10.
Yeah, Logan bought... That's what Logan brought. He brought that. That's why he played Advanced Warfare the next morning, because he had all his games with him.
Yeah.
Back when Logan used to pack, like, a whole bag worth of fucking Xbox games we would play.
Oh, yeah, we did the Skyrim race, too.
And he had the little TV on the table.
Yeah, that was part of the archives I did that I saved for, like, 2 years. So I forgot about it, and then I redid it.
Oh, that's an old-ass video.
In classic Logan fashion, he would just kill all the guards and then ask why he's getting chased.
Genius.
Throughout the entire map.
Oh, remember you got stuck because you started killing these two guards and you just couldn't fucking beat them. It was at night.
What was the challenge?
No, Ryan just invoked some fucking guards at some point, and your save point sucked. Or it was Logan.
No, that was him. I remember editing his point of view.
Because he got stuck, and these fucking guards kept kicking his ass.
He overwrote an old save or something, so he couldn't do anything. It was, and he would kill every chicken in sight and really good stuff.
It was fun.
And he kept walking. I remember one part specifically. Because he had the brightness turned down too low.
Oh, yeah, because he's and wondering, like, guys, he's I walking, can't
he's
see.
Like, he's like, is this the fucking entrance? He's like, over to your right. Your right. Your other right. Down the hole. And he kept walking to the wall, which was, ironically, the cave that leads you to the blind man reading a book with no words on it.
Where the fuck are my souls?
This is good stuff. The Hat Man.
Oh, God, the Hat Man's Shadow Ward.
You know what's sad is now that's like not even that bad of a Steam Greenlight game compared to the shit.
Compared
that's
to
happened.
The shit that's around. Oh no!
God, I'm so glad that's going away.
Can I have the pizza?
What,
please?
They're taking away Greenlight.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, they're moving.
It's turning into Steam Direct, so now they're gonna have a
Steam
little bit of filter around it. But thanks to the efforts of Total Biscuit and Jim Sterling, it is going away.
Steam Erect. Did this make you erect? Yes or no?
Steam erect, green
so
light.
Many asset flips. I am hard as a rock.
No, you fucker. I just be able to use the fucking Zway Hunter because this thing sucks.
Good luck with
ass.
That. Yeah, this is exactly why everyone gets the Drake Sword right off the bat.
Yeah, all you need is 20 strength. I just hate this game sometimes. All right. Speaking of the ending of stuff, let's talk about the ending of Dark Souls. If that's
it
something
is
we
over.
Want to talk about, but you played the DLC yet?
Oh, dude.
Oh, you did?
I played it through the night it came out because I wanted to watch people play the next day.
Okay.
No spoilers.
How long did it take you to beat Gale? It's 2 weeks, so we can talk about spoilers.
Yeah, I talked about it last week, so.
We can talk about all we want.
Probably, like, a good hour.
Oh, my brother beat him on a second try.
What the fuck?
Yeah. I told you, he's literally Shomer, but Dark Souls 3. I watched him parry Champion Gundyr 3 times. He didn't get a kick in. No kicks.
What?
No
he
kicks.
He always kicks.
He didn't kick. He killed him so fast he didn't kick.
Gundyr is like a lightning mule.
Who else? Who did he kill? He killed someone's... He killed the Crystal Sage so fast he didn't get a second phase. How?
See, I watch a lot of DS3 speedruns.
That's where he's learned.
And that's what they do.
Oh, he's learned.
I don't like to copy that because that would make my life feel terrible.
He beat the whole game with a barb sword. That you get from, whole game. Barbsword plus 10 from Kirk.
Good God.
And beat both DLCs with that. I watched him beat Freed one-on-one after Slave Knight Gale died. So she had double the health and beat her one-on-one.
Good God.
In third phase.
I've seen a, guy beat all of DS3 with Boulder Heave.
What the hell did you watch, Lobos?
No, this was a distortion.
Lobos fought Gwyn, fists only, 5 hours to beat him.
Yeah, five hours! I couldn't bear to watch his entire fist only playthrough.
It's beautiful. I love people to do that.
No, man, I thought Gale was a great fight, though.
Yeah,
me Artorias too. On steroids I with really the Matrix. The ending was perfect. At first, I hated it, and then I realized it makes sense.
Everything's futile.
Everything's futile. We're just
humans, and you can't change anything. Time means nothing.
Did you guys ever consider maybe we're in a painted world?
Yeah, I saw somebody comment that. That's a painted, and no matter what, you're repainting the next painted world, and it all happens over and over again. And it's literally this constant cycle of holy fuck.
Yep.
Which sounds totally legitimate.
I mean, there was 13 matrices or whatever in the Matrix, and there's the theory that the overworld in the Matrix is just another level of the Matrix, so...
The Matrix? Oh, it's what?
Too bad that last movie was so shit. Apparently there's going to be a reboot of the Matrix soon.
Are they going to use
Which
Keanu
is
Reeves?
The one series... The one series in existence that actually a reboot is canon. So that's kind of cool.
Huh.
It might. I don't know if it's going to be a prequel or a sequel, but, you know.
Sequel memes. Prequel memes. All the memes.
As long as Keanu...
The Matrix 2017 patch.
10 gigabyte day one patch! What?
They better have Hugo in it. Mr. Anderson.
Be wary of liar. I hate... Has Master Key, can't open this door.
Yep.
The reboot's sequel would be like... The Matrix, the DLC.
The DLC.
No, bruh. Gotta get a season pass to be able to enjoy this movie in its fullest.
So, Blake, you weren't mad at the Dark Souls ending?
You know what? I've been waiting on Vati to, like, make videos and tell me what the fuck happened. But and that just hasn't happened yet, so I can't really speculate.
Everybody's been waiting on that because he's literally the foremost source. If anyone plays Dark Souls and doesn't watch Vati video for anything...
He even knows it.
It wrong.
He said in a video, he's like, this takes me a while because I don't have Vati's videos to go watch.
Yeah.
Literally, he knows. This is what we do.
Well, last week, he made a video saying, yeah, in a couple days, I'll put something out talking about...
And everyone's just
it's
eagerly...
been 10 days, Vati!
And it's been fucking forever.
Everyone's eagerly refreshing their YouTube, like, alright, where's it at?
I literally check it, like, at least once or twice a day.
I get the notification whenever it comes up on my phone, so I'm eagerly awaiting so I can just jam out to it on the way home. So I've been watching like his old series. If you watch from the beginning,
I've watched every one of them.
Yeah, I think I've watched most of them.
If you watch it from the beginning, you can see his huge difference in production quality, though.
Yeah, yeah.
It is massive.
It says on his Patreon that he's working like on making videos that don't use gameplay as background, I think.
How do you do that?
Because he gets like a bunch of artists and animations
and
shit.
Oh, and they'll sit there and do it.
Yeah.
I mean, his community's got to be huge now. But, no, all he talked about in his latest video was like, yeah, I fucked up the Angels video. It's pretty wrong.
Yeah. Well, I was totally on board with the whole Velka theory and the girl in the cage too, but apparently all that's fucking meaningless too.
Meaningless?
So that's good.
Did I find this
guy? Okay. So what my question is, does anybody know what the fucking the shell is that
the little eggshell she's holding?
Yeah.
No idea. No idea. I thought maybe that had something to do with the birdcage, but don't see any other connection outside of that.
Yeah,
so.
That's what I was wondering.
There's nothing in it.
I think the shell might be the fragility of the world, was all I've seen someone say. It's like the fragility of like her mental state, and when you break it, it breaks the dream. So you're basically breaking the dream.
What asshole gave her an egg that if it breaks, it breaks her mind?
Gwyn.
What asshole made a... fucking Covenant, a boss fight. Fuck that shit. That was the worst thing about that DLC.
I finished...
You don't like the Spear of the Church?
Fuck that shit.
And only... Thank God I got a decent summon. And we killed everyone by one.
Yeah, I saw your shit. I waited for an hour and a half. No gold
that
signs.
That sucks shit, dude.
Wait, you fought it with a...
Did you go offline?
You fought it with a summon?
Yeah, I tried offline, but Half-Light's worse.
No, he's not.
Dude, he's so bad.
We beat him on New Game Plus 4.
He parried me 3 times.
Oh, no, I kicked it. We kicked his ass. But we used, what did we use? What were we using? Oh, just the Dark Sword.
Dark Sword's OP.
Dark Sword's OP. It was OP. Is the fucking twin great swords. That's the best fucking weapon I've ever seen in my entire life.
I thought he had dual fume knight swords.
That's what I was waiting. Well, I was like,
are you shitting
me right
now?
Well, I'm sitting with Jake, and he's looking on his phone because we played the DLC at his house first. And I look over him like, Jake. He's like, what? I was like, whoa.
With the balls.
And then he lights the fire up, and I'm like, he's gonna tear my asshole open.
Have either of you tried the humanity challenge?
I know what it is, and I couldn't do it.
I'm not doing that shit.
The thing with lap?
I'm not cold. I know, I haven't done that either. Wait, yeah, that's the thing with lap, isn't it?
Yeah, the humanity challenge goes with lap, yeah.
I mean, we know who lap is, right?
Yeah, it's Patches.
Patches.
Unbreakable asshole.
I love that as soon as he gets his personality back, he's like, oh yeah, go down and get that treasure for me, because I'm a fucking cock through every age.
Doesn't matter if it's Demon Souls, Dark Souls 1, Dark Souls 2. It
has to be the same series. I'm still a dick.
Was he in Dark Souls 2?
No.
That's the one game he wasn't in.
Because Miyazaki wasn't there. And that's his little... Yeah.
That's his thing. And the whole, I'm going to talk shit through NPCs about people criticizing my game. He totally does that. Like, because I saw somebody pull up like 3 or 4 quotes that he's made with the NPCs in various games. Talking shit about people getting mad because they're not... he's not putting enough stuff in the game for them to understand it. Maybe it's not supposed to be understood. Maybe it's like a teenage girl.
I did like how all the, like, every bug, I exhausted all their dialogue in the Ring City, talking to them about, like, who made it to the end.
Yeah.
They yeah.
talk about Havel and shit.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's funny because there's a couple NPCs from Dark Souls, what was it, from Dark Souls 1, or no, 2, that made it to the Ring City.
Yeah.
Alva made it to the Ring City.
Yeah, you fight as Phantom.
And, yeah.
I swear there was a Lucatil Miro.
There was a reference.
A reference.
Because it said
something
about...
And then there's a... What's his name? Oh, who's the guy that they said locked away Havel?
Laddersmith Gilligan.
The fact that he is in Dark Souls 3...
That was just like, why of all NPCs? But yeah, initially people thought it was going to... Like, Gwyn was his friend that locked him away.
No, it's the guy that...
Silver Knight Leto.
Yep.
That was Leto. Yep. Which, why is there a Silver Knight?
That guy's hammer.
Oh, that hammer is the most OP.
First time.
That thing's OP.
Scared the shit out of me when I was trying to fight Adjudicator Dickhead.
Did you actually fight him?
So when he's the guy summoning. I ran up there and I killed him. All you get is a fucking divine blessing and then he turns up again.
Did you? So I noticed that you missed the path because I have been watching your playthrough, Ryan. And you did miss a path somewhere. Did you fight the dark spirit of Leto?
No.
I knew he was there, but I didn't. You can't fight him after Gale.
Yeah.
You can't? Really?
No, you have to kill him before you kill Gale.
That's good.
Yep, fun fact, you have to kill him before you kill Gale.
Put that on my New Game Plus 2 checklist. Because I got a lot of shit to do there.
Alright, this guy's just a fucking asshole. Why can I not get a backstab?
Because the timing on the backstabs on this game is just cancer. And
I was better on the fucking 360.
I know. It probably has something to do with
I got the Black Knight shield.
Not the sword that you want, but
fucking
the shield.
Fucking neat.
Put on that gold covetous serpent ring that you don't have. Make things easy. Yeah, I've got like 5 more rings to get in New Game Plus 1 anyway, and then...
Favorite ring off that. Ring of favorite protection +3.
I want to give a big shout out to Dark Souls for not adding achievements with DLC. That's something
that's
I love
some
about that.
That's some fucking
bullshit. Thank you for that, because it's...
It's asshole-ish.
No, it's great, because I don't have to go back.
Oh, it's asshole-ish to add in the achievements.
Oh, yeah, no, it's awful.
That's what I'm saying. How did you...
Chloranthrium ring +3 is awesome.
Oh, my God, yeah.
I put the ring of favorite protection +3.
What did you guys think of Ass Eater Madeir?
Brother beat him first try.
2 hours later.
I stopped summoning people.
Me too.
His health was too great, everybody was so stupid.
It took about 3 tries of summoning. I was like, you know what? This is one of those bosses. It's just not going to work. So
it was about the 5th try when I realized I couldn't go pussy mode and run under him. I had to look him in the fucking mouth.
Yeah, because his head's his weak spot, so they got real fun. Well, they pulled a fucking Dark Souls 2 Wyvern thing. The legs are bullshit, and the head's the only thing that hurts.
Except this one actually moves and doesn't have a completely predictable pattern. Like, New Game Plus 1, I ran in there naked with a lightning halberd and kicked his ass immediately.
It's more like King of the Storm. His head's the only thing that fucking hurts.
Yeah, that's... Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's what it is. Asshole. Whee-yah! That didn't work.
But yeah, he pushed my shit in plenty of times.
Right in the pooper.
And if I didn't have all SS Flasks, there's no way I would have made it through that fight.
I mean, sometimes it didn't even matter if he had plenty of Estus. One shot, the fucking fire in my laser.
Charge my laser!
That laser is the coolest fucking attack I've ever seen in my life, though. I fucking love it. I think it's cool as hell.
I finally figured out his little pattern, and I would get, like, 2 feet away from where it was blowing up behind me, he can run to his face.
The only after you figured it out, it wasn't so bad. But the only attack I thought was bullshit was the tail attack. That the fucking hit registration on that attack is crazy.
And the thing I hate about those kind of attacks is like the fucking tail you can walk through half the time. It won't even hit, but yet when he's spinning around, it'll fuck your world up. It makes no sense.
Oh, he also had that attack where
the lunge. There was no tail. Like, if he waited too long, that was the only way you could tell that he was about to do something. But he ran through me so many fucking times doing that.
I actually
You want the residence key. You know we do.
Yeah.
As
East-West Shield.
I liked the fight a lot. I thought it was like...
Me too.
The Ancient Dragon of Dark Souls 2 should have been.
Yeah, it was definitely... Yeah, I didn't rage at it. I was like, all right, this guy's legit. He's not just
bullshit.
That's
what I did with Gale. I was like, this is Artorias on steroids with the Matrix added in. Because, like, attacks similar to Artorias. Then you go to second stage, and he has AoE with similar attacks. Third stage, he, like, can flip in the air, shoot lightning from the sky, and fire lightning bolts from his repeater crossbow.
Dude, the repeater crossbow attacks were fucking insane.
That's why I bought that immediately with his soul. I don't immediately. Know if I'll ever use it.
Oh, no, we bought his sword. His sword is fucking hoss.
Yeah, his sword is
pretty his hoss.
So the question is, what order should you play the fucking DLC in the main game?
Before you finish it or after?
Yeah.
Or do you like go... Let's wonder, do you go to the Painted World,
As soon leave, as you can,
finish the game, and then go fight Gale after you beat the Soul Sender? Or what?
Or before.
Or before the Soul Sender. Like, what do you do? Because the problem is, like, is the DLC... Like, DLCs aren't supposed to be in the same time span, but this could totally be in the same time span.
At the end, I feel like when you fight Gale, it's, like, a lot later than when you fight the Souls.
Oh, no, it's a whole lot.
I feel like it's, like, supposed to be the same time period.
You think something? Well, I thought that, but because the Dregkeep's still more put together, like, as much as the Dregkeep is, it's more put together than the area you fight Gale in.
This is very true. I feel like it's just a different area.
Well, see, I guess I can kind of agree with Blake there, because, like, when you get to the Dregkeep, it's all collapsed in, like, the Soul of Cinder arena. Whereas when you walk out of Filianor, it's just fucking ash. There is nothing there. It's like the top of Anor Londo is what's left, not the bottom. So I can agree there. That's what I thought it was later, just because. Well, the thing they pointed out too was I don't know, because you can say like where the sun goes out is when that happens, but at the same time when you fight the Soul Cinder, the sun's gone.
Yeah, it's just fucking.
There's just the dark sign.
Yeah,
that's fucking hard.
Body.
Did you hurry guys? Did you guys walk around the Gale arena?
Oh yeah,
afterwards?
Oh yeah.
You'll fight old dickhead, that girl or whatever her name is.
Slut.
Yeah, I went back.
How
after
the
I was
fuck
the
do
series.
I get to the Lower Undead Burg? Does anyone remember?
You need a key of some sort.
Do I have to have the residence key for that?
You open it up that way from the depth.
But how do I get down there? Because you have to get that to get the key to the depths.
Go to the.
Oh, I know where it's at. Yeah. I know where to go. I don't know if I have the key, but I know where to go.
Yeah, going from the other way.
Yeah,
did we fought the Dark Tarsh Demon yet?
Yeah, we did. Ryan, we had to if we got to the Gargoyles.
Yeah, we did.
How far are we?
I don't remember any of this shit.
I don't either, but yeah.
Just initiate. Right now.
What the fuck? There's people that have gotten his club first try.
I've never gotten it. It just makes me so mad.
You get his club?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the only people I've ever seen, like, I've read do it, is they don't die before they even get to him. Like, they have to go flawless run and then get to him.
I feel like that's a fucking myth.
Mm-hmm. Me too. I just feel like it's a 1 in 100 drop.
Alright, now we're going to the depths. The Lower Undead Burg. I remember playing this for the first time. Oh, I forgot. You can't just slide down the fucking ladder anymore.
Miyazaki. Modders, please. There's something they could add to the wiki. That's a surprisingly active wiki page, even though you could get banned for using the shit.
What?
Anything that's other than like... Hell, you could get banned for using DS Fix, technically.
The fuck? What? Why?
Because it modifies frame rate. And it's unfair, some bullshit.
It's unfair, well, you know...
Fix your fucking game, how about that?
Pussy bar.
It's a miracle we got PC ports anyway, so can't complain too much.
Really? Oh, wait, no. Did I invoke the dogs yet? No, I didn't invoke the dogs. I hate. This is the kind of bullshit that they did in this game. This door opens super fucking weird.
Yep.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
And it has to be from that angle, and everything's connected because yeah, this game.
There's just certain parts of this game that are just janky as fuck. Now, here's like the giant wall.
My wall.
So, is this similar to the wall from Dark Souls 2? Well, High Wall of Lothric or the Dark Souls 2 in Ivory King. Because he had a wall surrounding his area, too.
Walls are definitely a motif. In the, trying to separate the peasants.
Trying to incorporate Dark Souls 2 into the... To the
it's hard,
quotes,
into the meta.
It's hard enough, goddammit.
Into the meta.
Is almost impossible.
No, Elijah Smith Gilligan was in the profane capital. It's not that hard to connect it.
I would still like to just fucking think it's all a dream when you jump into that big...
Oh, yeah, my brother thinks in that whole thing that you actually have, like, you're super sick, and you just kind of, like, escape reality through that dream. Then again, they already use the dream premise, and they tell you that it's a dream, a.k.a. Bloodborne. So I don't know if it's a dream, because they would tell you. Because From tells you, like, hey, this is a dream. This right here is cheap bullshit.
Yeah.
Cheapo bullshit.
Guys, what if the world that the white-haired girl is painting is Bloodborne?
I saw that too.
Fucked.
That it's blood. Also saw somebody say it was the black blood was period blood, and that was a full-on conversation on the internet.
That's interesting. That's an interesting theory.
Does the menstrual cycle exist in Dark Souls?
I don't know, but this needs to stop.
I mean, there's other types of cycles, so maybe it does.
I don't need to help him out.
You don't get the key. He's such a good guy.
He just is like
he'll go hollow like everyone else.
Don't you dare go hollow. I don't need to go that way.
Oh, sure you do. They look so friendly.
Okay, so I'm going to try to get real lore heavy here.
Okay.
So
this has become the ending stream to the Let's Dark Souls lore it out, but they get the premise here. It's fine.
So you touch the egg.
Yes.
Does time, like, skip forward? Or was that what it was supposed to be all along?
It's what it was supposed to be all along, and her dream shrouded it like Anorlando, is what I thought. Like, her powers were great enough while she was asleep.
It was just like killing Gwendolyn. And
yeah. Except, it wasn't like... I think her dream, like, she was such a powerful god that it kept the Ring City in that state.
See, that's why I think that it's the...
I could see that.
That's why I think that it all takes place the same time as when... Because, like... When you teleport from, when you put all the embers in, you know, the Lord's embers, whatever, mm-hmm. and then you teleport from the shrine,
it goes
the ruined
shit shrine, yeah.
That's like in the future.
Yeah.
Eons past, whatever. I think that because the Drag Keep's there, the Ring City is just an illusion that her dream, her consciousness, whatever, is keeping in that state. And as soon as you shatter that, it goes to what it really looks like.
Yeah.
There, the ashes and everything. So...
See, I can't tell if it's like...
So how did Gale get past that?
I have no fucking clue.
Because he's a slave knight. He doesn't fucking die. That's why I think it's in the future. Because the whole thing of slave knights is, no matter what, they will not die. Period. They go back to battle over and over and over. They're on the front lines with the Black Knights when all that went down. They were there. But...
I was there, man.
Like, they were there fighting the dragons, but they would die, and they would come back to life every single fucking time.
So, Gale, okay, so when that illusion breaks then, and...
Just throw some bombs.
You go to the current state of what the Ring City is. He is eating the pygmy's mm-hmm. souls, right?
Yes.
So, my question is, why does he ask to eat your dark soul?
Because every human has a dark soul. It's just pygmies are complete dark soul. You're dark and light. Like, you have a parallel within you.
So why couldn't he just go around eating humans?
Because the pygmies are complete dark soul.
It's like the whole Nephilim thing.
Yeah, they're like the pygmies, what they
Diablo.
Were.
Diablo. You're part angel, you're part demon.
What the hell?
There's also a biblical reference. Fall on his ass.
The problem is, I want to kill the dogs first.
There's one. I don't know that I've ever fought this guy without a Drake sword.
It's
Death
hard.
By dog.
But yeah, you need a stabby, so that's stabby. What I read was like pygmies in their own right are completely just. They're only just Dark Soul is what they are. That's why they're so like weird and creepy, because they're just human.
Just dark. like you are when you do the quest line for bitch face.
Yeah. So were the locusts, were they pygmies?
The what?
The locusts. The locusts. Bug people.
The bug people. What Let bug? The feast begin.
Oh, I don't think they were. I think
they're displaced from their area.
Area, like a bunch of stuff in the Ring City. Because like the Ring Knights are supposed to be there, but I don't know about like... There might be another group like the weirdo dudes that just had the weird black face and they're all, what the fuck are they called, Halder Knights or whatever?
Mm-hmm.
Like they came in pursuit of the Dark Soul and they got stuck because the Dark Soul consumed them, basically. I don't think they're pygmies. I think pygmies were their thing in their own right. And at first I thought, while there was all those like freaking, what was it? While there was all those thrones around that area, they were going to try and link the first flame. And I think they were just sitting there, like, after I thought about it, I didn't think they were just sitting there talking about the end of the world. They didn't know what to do. And that's where Gale found them, because he's trying to find the Dark Soul for his lady. Because I saw this really, like, super good hentai drawing. Not really hentai, but, like, this full-on drawing of, like, how Gale conquered all these different people to bring her different...
World 34 Gale.
To bring her different pigments. Like, she wanted blue, he went and killed an Outrider Knight. She wanted red, he went and killed something else. And that's all he did.
She wanted black.
She wanted black, you have to get the Dark Soul. And the only way to find the Dark Soul is he's just searching and searching and searching, and since he's a slave knight, he can't die. And that's how he finds the pygmies eventually, is his search.
Man, just burn some wood. Use coal.
Really?
It exists in this game. I've seen it.
These dogs are fucking stupid. I'm glad they didn't bring these back.
All this poetic bullshit.
Wax poetic, Ryan. Wax poetic.
So the next thing they make... You think it's going to be Bloodborne 2? You think it's going to be Armored Core? Because they're going back to Armored Core.
I think they're going to do another Armored Core.
I'm so looking forward to it. I hope.
They shouldn't do another Bloodborne. I think it's done, or should be done.
I think so too, but you never know.
Well, I mean, they made a ton of money off it. It was a fucking console
seller.
Right,
it made so much more money than Demon's Souls.
Oh, yeah. Well, it was a one-off thing. Well, the graphics were fucking amazing. I mean, it was...
Ran like Dookie, but...
Well, it was before Dark Souls 3, so you had the amazing graphics with the shitty, scary atmosphere and everything's fucking hard and disgusting. And it's just a very different premise. Like, it was way more disgusting than Dark Souls has ever been.
Oh, yeah.
Like, every boss...
Yeah, some of the bosses
gross.
Just, like...
The Bloodstar Beast was literally like a menstrual sheath with teeth.
Just the hair effects in that game still like
Yeah.
They come out. 2015?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Gaping Dragon doesn't have anything on the wet nurse.
Yeah,
no. Murgo's wet nurse is also a cheap ass boss fight when you figure it out. It's super fucking cheap.
Did you ever beat that, Blake?
Huh? Oh, no, I never played it.
I beat it.
You've got it installed, don't you?
Yeah, I know. I'm just...
It's really fun.
I can't talk shit. I've got like 30 games installed on my Xbox One.
This way to the witch!
It's just something you gotta set aside time for it to be angry.
Yeah.
You know?
You're not wrong.
I understand.
I remember fighting this guy for the first time when I originally played Dark Souls.
It's a good camera. Great camera. The best.
I'm fucked.
This is the worst trade deal in the history of Dark Souls. Maybe ever.
It's an alternative camera, Ryan.
Is it?
Okay, I just got fucked from the ride out there. I'm way better at this game than this, but goddamn.
Fake controls.
Actually, my favorite video is this one.
New favorite Hands video. Down. Hands down.
Hands down, Flame Stone Plate Ring. 10 out of 10, would fight again.
It's good stuff. Look how far we've come. We went from a 360 to this.
Let's see how far we've come.
Still playing the same fucking game.
I believe the world
is coming to an
end. I
don't know that my computer even knows that it's running a game right now.
No,
it's like on idle.
You could probably play another game.
Yeah, I probably play Battlefield 1.
Play not GTA 5 and this game and Battlefield 1 at the same time.
Let's see. I need to buy a premium for Battlefield 1, but I just don't have time to play it like I want to right now.
My friend turned on his Xbox the other day because he has Battlefield 1 for Xbox One, and it just said, "Hey, you got premium. Congratulations."
He didn't pay for it?
And he didn't pay for it.
What a cock.
Hey,
yeah, this game
premium.
Kicks you off when it can't figure out that you have the key to the DLC. Hey, bro, I know you paid, but we don't see it, so fuck
off. I remember that.
I had that happen to me halfway through the deer fight.
Yeah, me too. I was that close, and it kicked me off.
Ha ha.
Good old digital DRM. Great stuff. It's only going to get worse.
Where the fuck did you... Where did you come from? He followed, I killed everyone in that room.
He followed you.
This game is the worst for following. Like, holy shit.
They got a range. No doubt about it. So, I believe the last time we talked on the podcast about games this year, looking forward to, I said Breath of the Wild. It's already out, and I just... Every time I say, all right, I want to beat Ganon today, I go and do 10 more shrines and side quests, so I've still yet to beat the game, but still really good. No 10 out of 10. That's a little ridiculous. No 7 out of 10, because Jim Sterling's just a troll and trying to boost his reviews, but still very good. Blake, did you say Mass Effect Andromeda was your most anticipated?
I made a grave error.
Could anyone have seen this coming, of it being just...
horrendous
animation memes for years to come? Like,
see, I didn't watch any trailers because I don't like to spoil stuff for myself, and I don't even know if I had watched those if I would have known how garbage it was going to be. Like,
I'm at a rape circle again,
because you know they made it, because Dragon Age Inquisition had the open world aspects. Mass Effect should not have that.
No
what they thought it should.
Because that's the new buzzword, is open world.
Open world.
So now all you do is just drive a shitty car around for 80% of the game. Because, you know, everyone loved that section in Mass Effect 1.
Jesus, that was the worst.
Now, let's do it 10 times as much. Also, let's have the cheesiest one-liners in the history of video games. Because
is it better than
now.
The one-liners we saw in that Donkey video earlier?
Gecko, sadly, no.
New Gecko 64 or whatever sadly, the hell it's called.
That's worse than... playing Jenga at Michael Fox's house.
But yeah. I'm not, like, honestly, it's really weird, I guess, for me, like, on the weird subject of Dark Souls 3. Is that a really, I guess, sentimental attachment to that game? Because it's the first, like, playing this game right here got me back into enjoying video games again. Like, it brought back faith in video games. And me building a PC brought me back to actually playing video games like I used to. Because when I was younger, I played all the fucking time. Like, I enjoyed the hell out of it. And going back and playing this and then building a PC post beating this game, like, revitalized my passion.
And now most stuff is just, it's just shit. It's just objective. And it's not nostalgia goggles, because I can go back, I can play Halo 3 and be like, yeah, this game's still fucking amazing. And then play modern shit. It's like, what happened? I'm glad that now everything's run by 13-year-old focus groups.
Yeah, I'm disappointed that as much as I dream... and, you know, pray. There's not going to be... I mean, Elder Scrolls 6, it's not going to be Skyrim.
Mm-mm. We're going to play it. We're going to do one playthrough of it and be like, well...
Well, that was like... It's going. You know what? It's going to be like... That reminded me of Fallout 4.
Uh-huh.
That's the hard thing to swallow, because we got Halo 3, Fallout 3, and Skyrim. But then you get Halo 4, Fallout 4, and how am I... Can you...
Nope.
Ha!
No, you can't.
But it's like, it's
Call of Duty 4, ones that before everything went to shit.
Like, we had some really good stuff we played, and then you get the sequels, like, and it just sucks.
How amazing a year 2007 was for video games. What exclusive came out for PlayStation 3 in 2007? I know there was something big. It wasn't like the first Uncharted, was it? Was it Killzone? Or
it might have been Killzone.
I swear Killzone... It was Killzone 2.
I thought that was like 2008. No. I don't remember. But I remember, like, COD 4 and Bioshock came out, and then Halo 3 for 360, but I know there was something else big for PlayStation 3. The original Crysis, it was just a huge year.
I'm not going to lie. I think it's kind of a kid's game, but Little Big Planet came out that year.
Little Big Planet!
I knew there was something else.
That game was fucking fun.
It was revolutionary. A lot better than 3.
I mean, it's just, like, hard to swallow the fact of, like, you played Halo 3, you loved it, and then you got Halo 4.
Halo 4 was... I liked the campaign a lot in 4, actually. 5.
Well, now you have Halo 5.
Shit. Oh, my God.
That's my thing. Well, it's like with Halo... like
Halo 6 better be better
than... Well, to me, it's like...
3 and 4 combined.
Halo 4 gives me the same shitty vibe that Gears 4 does. Like, they could have ended the series on a pretty decent note,
but
they decided to milk it.
Uncharted was 2007.
I knew it was something big. So, yeah, that was a fucking crazy
year. What else came out in
07?
What was the Xbox? Or it was
Halo 3. That was the big one.
Raw 2 came out, which was a big one.
Yep.
You know,
yep.
Ghost Recon.
Mm-hmm.
Assassin's Creed.
I was going to say it was either 07 or 08.
That was a huge year for gaming then, Jesus.
Yeah, like I said.
What year did Gears 2 come out?
2008, because Gears 1 was 06. Then Modern Warfare 2 in 2009, and then Bad Company 2 a few months later.
I got parried, and my throat slit.
Oblivion was that year, too.
Yeah, this
is 2006, but nope. I guess no.
March 20th, 2000.
That's hilarious that it came out the same year as Halo 3. Because it, right. Like, it looks like it came out 10 years before it.
So did Rock Band.
Rock Band.
And the Orange Box.
Guitar Hero.
Oh, yeah, Orange Box.
I want you to know there's like an OG PC version of Half-Life at Peddler's Mall here in Winchester. Like, in a box.
It's like $2.
I don't know, but I want to buy it just for the fucking nostalgia. Yes, I know Ambush Ahead.
I remember... Devin brought over the Orange Box, and I played, like, because my desktop could run Team Fortress 2 a little bit, and I played it on that. So
the tracking,
playing the TF2 on 360 was just a nightmare. I was like, how is this the same game? This is the worst piece of shit.
So the the four worst games that came out for the PS3 2007, Super Rub-A-Dub. Fantastic Four Rise of the Silver Surfer.
Oh, good. I remember that. I remember that.
Sonic the Hedgehog.
Yep.
And The Golden Compass.
Oh, God. Sonic 06, man. Good stuff. Good stuff. I don't remember.
Oh, what have I not used
that yet? Does Rub-A-Dub have Bubba Ducky in it? That's what matters.
Bubba Ducky. Suck on my dick.
I distinctly remember it being on the store. I couldn't tell you what it's about.
And Bubba Ducky, you play as Bubba Ducky.
Sometimes. But yeah, if we haven't hit our peak already in video game quality, it's coming very soon. And
I mean,
and
I guess
then we live a life full of cynic.
As I think
filled rage.
Story-wise, we might have hit our peak with a lot of games. Like, graphics-wise, no. But like, legitimate, like, story-wise, like, Halo. What the fuck, man?
Yeah.
That's damn good.
Yeah.
Like, you've had some really good fucking stories.
Assassin's Creed, the early ones.
I mean, the only thing of recent times that's made me, like, more hopeful is The Last of Us.
And that was, like... You mean The Order 1887 wasn't a cinematic experience that beats all?
Where they reuse the same three QuickTime events over and over?
What about Quantum Break? You tell me that's not a great... out. Kill me now.
They will, don't worry.
What about
Killer Instinct? The new campaign mode of that is just flawless.
I can't believe we played that. What did you text me saying that we said?
I don't remember.
Well, is that a cock in your ass or an ass
in
your cock?
Yeah, I was like, what is this
something?
Ass cock doing? And I was like, he puts cocks in asses. I don't know. It was a legitimate quote. I was like, what the fuck were we playing? It's good stuff. No way I'll find it, but it was good times.
Yeah, it's been enjoyable. I'm trying to think. What do you think our funniest video was, like, for me and you? Like, I guess...
Just us two together?
I guess in general, like, what's the funniest thing we've ever done?
Most gut-wrenching thing would definitely have Logan in it, but I don't remember...
I don't even pick one specifically.
Probably the This Way to the Witch episode
that
of
was,
Dark Souls.
Oh,
Jesus Christ.
Logan, when you tried to fight the Moonlight Butterfly was just too fucking much for my soul.
It really was. That one was fantastic. As far as, like, intentionally just trying to get a rise out of people, my proudest ones is one of probably the Infinite Warfare sneak peek one. I was feeling salty that day, and it came across pretty well. I like that one. It's funny to me that I just have like two videos that over 100,000 views, and
we're a bunch.
Subscribers don't work out how they used to. Let's say that much.
Yeah,
you could get a million views and you're like guaranteed 10 grand subscribers like right off the bat. Now it's like no one even knows what that function does, and people that sub don't understand what subs do. It's like you subscribe to someone because you want to see more of their videos, and
yes.
You're alerted when the videos come out. So if you're not going to watch any fucking videos, just
why
don't
do you
even subscribe.
That's why
I don't care. Like, that's a useless number to me. New channel, we have 60 subs and averaging more than that a video already. So
I guess this is relevant. What's your guys' take on the whole, like, pulling ads thing?
I'm it could not have come at a better time for us to back out, let me say that much.
Yes.
It's ridiculous.
Is Cowchop getting the rads pulled?
Not yet.
Because I saw that fucking...
Funhouse is. Because, well, to be fair, their titles and thumbnails are softcore porn 90% of the time. So I could totally see why. It's stupid. They need to have it... You cannot do this as a automated system if they're going to do it this way and try to keep legitimate subscribers around or legitimate advertisers around. And at the very least, they could do it, you know, have 10 employees do the biggest 1,000, you know, channels across YouTube or whatever, moderate those, but it's so fucking dumb.
My thing is, can we please...
YouTube's just going to shit.
Get people to stop doing just fucking clickbait shit.
Oh, no, never.
Like, legitimate YouTubers just doing clickbait shit.
It's never going to end.
Like, why? Like, I get it, you know, some things are important, but I feel like once you've been doing this for so long, you know what clickbait shit is.
Yeah, but
we've never done clickbait shit.
At that point, you know, I mean, hell, most of the original people we used to watch have been bought out by companies, right? Like
Rooster Teeth.
You know, Rooster Teeth got bought out. Rooster Teeth acquired a ton of other small YouTube channels, and now they have.
Can I stop getting parried, please?
They have to make money to send back to big old RT.
Mm-hmm. And they're not doing it through just merch and ad spots and all that alone. So, yeah, I really hate seeing so many channels that are like, when they're on the teeter-totter between amateur and like full-blown production is when they're at their best. Creatures, before they went to shit. Rooster Teeth, before they went to shit for the most part.
Mm-hmm.
All that. It was like, there was passion behind it.
Dude, I can't watch anything.
No, it's fucking unbearable. Especially, I mean, I got out about a month into when they let the new employees, Matt and Jeremy, start playing more. And I was like, I'm sorry, guys, I can't do it.
They're not funny.
At least some, you know, like, that's what I really love about Cowchop. They understand if you're going to try to make someone a personality, you have to set them up correctly. And they did a perfect job with Trevor. I fucking love Trevor.
Trevor's good.
But you can't just throw them in.
Yeah, they had like...
And help the community.
2 weeks of content. They put them in one special video with the VR thing and, you know, edited out the awkward parts. Or I mean, the whole thing was fucking awkward, but on intention. And then now everyone loves them. And I'm pretty sure they let go of Aaron because of that. Because he wasn't fitting in on that. And he didn't want to move probably to LA, but yeah, I'm just so sick of the...
Wait, who let go Aaron? Cowchop?
Yeah.
Why?
Because he didn't want to move.
Huh.
Primarily is what Alex said, but there's probably some... Not him not wanting to be in videos and whatever else. I can't see him shocked. Either way, they're moving to what looks like a big warehouse with a kitchen in it, and the creatures are now in a crack house, so I think...
Oh, man, they couldn't pay the rent in that giant office space anymore? I wonder why.
Yeah, with just like 5 people and none of them are funny? Crazy.
Mostly Spencer having probably charges against him for being fucking creepy? God, he's so creepy.
Yeah, now's not a good time to be a super group on YouTube, I guess.
See, what I used to love watching Markiplier when I first started because my roommate showed me him and I thought he was great.
It's really sad how many... There's like Markiplier... And PewDiePie and so many other Jacksepticeye, like they did an interview with him on the official podcast. They're like, they're good dudes, like they're cool, but I cannot fucking stand the videos they make.
What?
Especially
I was going through the fog.
Not in this game, bro. They don't give a shit. And if you do kill them, they're going to come after you immediately after. So, oh god. But yeah, I mean, I didn't find that kind of shit funny even when I was in the target audience, let alone now. Top of the morning to you!
Yeah, he's not very exciting to me.
Who's that one douchebag that's like, has sexual charges against him now?
Tobuscus?
No, there was one before them.
I don't remember. Can he fall down?
Nah. He's got that poise. He's got that.
Literally, the dog kept him from falling down. I give up on this fucking shit.
YouTube gaming is a fucking rough business nowadays. If I was doing it, I mean, I don't have the patience nor the time to be a streamer. But if you want to do one of the two, it's all streaming now.
I've shifted my entire like viewing over to Twitch.
Cow Chop is streaming's only Let's Plays I watch anymore. I watch nothing but reviews and tech shit on YouTube.
I like streaming, though. Like, I do enjoy watching Twitch.
The crowd interaction's good for a good streamer. A bad streamer is fucking unbearable, but a good streamer is...
Mm-hmm. Hey, guys, if I'm a girl, I'm going to show my titties. What?
Basically.
Can you not?
That donkey video. I will see my cat.
It's like, I literally just came here to play... I came here to watch video games.
Well, it's if I wanted, a cup!
If and I honestly, wanted titties, I would be on Pornhub.
And there are some, like... There are definitely, like, bad popular streamers.
Oh, yeah. Oh, like, yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
And this is probably, not popular opinion, but Man vs. Game...
I hate it.
Unbearable. It's fucking unbearable.
I've never watched it.
Well,
I watch Boogie on stream, and I watch... Lobos on stream, that's about it.
I love watching people play Dark Souls. And man plays Dark Souls up like it's 50% of his content.
So, us on this channel.
Think about every 5 steps you take, stopping.
Reading the chat,
and then having a heartfelt discussion or a rant every time took 5 steps. I'm like, play the fucking game!
Mm-hmm.
I forgot how big the following was on this game.
Yeah, heartfelt discussion. I agree, it's fucking unbearable. I really like the Happy Hobbit. He's great for Dark Souls. Shit.
I don't know if he's ever going to no hit run Dark Souls 3 with all the DLC.
No, but he hits a good playthroughs. I also love when someone donates a certain amount of money. He like stops it. He turns on some like echo and reverb and reads this big long passage. And
oh, did you guys notice that this was in Dark Souls 3 DLC?
Noticed it immediately.
But there statue.
Not immediately. It took me like.
Well, I noticed. I saw the hole. I'm like, holy shit. But they took this out.
Yep. Because the...
Oh, also, fun fact, you wake him up and you jump in the hole, he disappears. He basically says, fuck you.
That's good.
Yeah, if you just jump in the hole next to him, and you can fall straight into, like, below Firelink, he gets mad. He's like, I never want to talk to you again.
That's good.
What a dick.
Hey, kill Fatty Ding Dong like Logan tried to. He's like, that's my brother. Kicked. Brother Ham Hawks.
I'm literally so black right now.
You are,
My character is ugly.
You are pot roast, there's no doubt.
Fuck that guy.
Burnt pot roast.
Get a few warning shots.
Yeah, in the back. After getting pulled over. But yeah, not a great time to start a gaming channel. Not a good time to start any channel, really. Fortunately, we're venturing into something that's not quite as saturated, but still. It's not a great time to be trying to make money off the old YouTube.
Hey, if I kill Lordrick now, do you think... I'll get away with, or he won't kill the firekeeper. Trying it.
Doing so little.
Kick him off.
He's just going to go to the next set of stairs. I've done this.
I know. What's kick forward right bumper?
Nope. It only works half the time.
Except in DS3. Then it works at every least time 10% of the time when you're not trying to do it.
Yep.
There you go.
You showed him.
You need a roundhouse.
Fuck!
He's gonna sickle you.
He pulled out like a fucking
parrying dagger
knife for a second there.
Also, you're not allowed to backstab.
He has a what? I forgot. I can't backstab at all.
Oh, fucking gold prick.
But honestly, I thought about it. I'm like, if YouTube loses like a bunch of revenue. I just can't imagine a different service.
No.
You know?
There's no competition. Like
Pornhub.
Yeah. Mm. Vimeo.
I mean, everything I hear else. There's a lot of Overwatch stuff happening there.
Yeah. So I hear.
Can we stop with the Overwatch bullshit? Like, I am so done with Overwatch.
Yeah, I mean, I was never into
it. It just feels like it's not a fun game to watch someone fucking play.
It's not. I hate it.
It's just like Team Fortress 2 is not a fun game to watch. It's like
I love playing it, though. I enjoy playing Overwatch. It's a fun game sometimes, especially when I can shoot rockets people and piss them off. I should try parrying this bastard.
I can't tell you how... There you go.
First shot!
How annoyed I am that the PC Master Race MOBA category for Game of the Year is Overwatch.
What?
What?
Like, do we need to go over what a MOBA is? They... There you go. The developers of League of Legends coined the term MOBA because they were tired of their game being called a Dota. Because it's not a Dota, it's League of Legends.
Yeah.
So, pretty fucking sure that just because there's people in it and it's a battle arena does not make it a MOBA. I think we know what type of game we're talking about.
PlayerUnknown's Battleground for MOBA of the year.
I'm fine. Oh, yeah.
That game's fucking fun. I don't know if you guys have looked into it.
Parry season.
You're getting a whole 23 damage with that. That big old
club. Oh, that's not good.
Yeah, he's doing his fun stuff.
I feel like Shomer. Well, you're fucking done, bitch, and you're not gonna kill my firekeeper.
Get good, scrub.
Will she ever talk?
No.
Can you do that?
She cut her. That's why, you know why she can't talk?
Yeah.
Cut her tongue out.
That always pissed me off. You could talk without a tongue.
I hear you.
You sound like a dumbass.
Yeah,
talk.
You just sound like you're deaf, basically.
Hey, man. What up, man?
Hey, nigga, nigga.
Yeah. Basically, sound like the South Park characters.
Yeah, it's like.
Fine.
Ever seen it? It's like the mind thing. It's like the different stages. Yeah. It's like, they took our job. They took our job.
Unfortunately. So, what's your all's revised most anticipated game this year? Shut up, Xbox.
What did I even say what my anticipated game was this year? What did I say it was? I can't remember.
Xenoverse 2 is already out.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's what I was saying. That was my like best game this year. I said something. What the fuck was my anticipated?
But, yeah, I have... I'm fingers crossed for a Halo 3 remaster. That's all I'm fucking caring about. I want to play the... Battlefield DLC eventually, and that's about it.
Can I have a pizza, please? I'm trying to think. I said something. I can't remember what the fuck it was.
Supposed to be a World War II Call of Duty this year.
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
Hell yeah.
Who would have saw that coming?
After the success of Battlefield 1, I sure didn't. Hashtag certainly not out
Man,
of ideas.
I do not miss this lighting.
So flawless.
I don't even know. I have no idea what games are coming out anymore.
I can name more titles for the Switch that I know are coming out than anything else.
That's because you shopped the store.
Exactly.
Because you had extra money.
Except their coming soon page is fucking abysmal, and I had to just go on the subreddit.
Get that ass.
Ugh! Fuck you, Shrek!
When your weapon does literally no fucking damage to these guys...
This is my swamp now.
Yeah, I really need, like, souls big time.
Get in
so I
my
get the
belly.
This is getting real fucking cheap. Like, I just killed Lordtrick like it was nothing. My weapon does no
damage. At
least
he's finally letting you fucking backstab.
Yeah, I know. They're just like, oh, no backstabs? This guy has the largest backstab hitbox you've ever seen.
Imagine having to do this with your fist.
Oh, that would be great. Over and over and over.
It's all Lobos for you. Why are you, like, he didn't hurt me. Why? Oh, yeah, I forgot how many souls these guys give you. Because I came from the other side because I didn't have the master key. Because I didn't know you're supposed to have the master key the first time I played this. So I came through the other side and just harvested souls for hours. Because I thought Blight Town was supposed to be the worst thing of all time. And it kind of was.
I'd say this year's E3 has got to be interesting.
Especially with Xbox Scorpio announced.
Hey, is that supposed to come out at the end of this year?
Yeah. It's basically like a 1070 equipped Xbox.
Ooh, and it's going to cost like $5 million?
Probably. If it's $500, though, they'll kick PS4 Pro's ass.
If it's $500, I'll buy one. Oh, you fucking dick.
If it's $500, I'll go, that's $500 more for a GPU. Fuck you, Microsoft.
Yep, exactly.
I kind of hope my brother buys a Switch. Like, I'm really banging.
They said that you can play anything that's coming out on both of them, so if I have to run Halo 6 or whatever when the fuck it comes out, hopefully they get smart and release everything on PC when it comes out. That would be the nice thing to do. But we'll see. Yep, that's... I have nothing else either. Fingers crossed for something from Software on Switch, so I can take the rage on the go and throw it on the plane at someone's head when I get pissed off.
Didn't they say they were partners with Nintendo again?
I'm feeling Armored Core, but boy, a whole Dark Souls series on Switch would be great.
Oh, yeah, fucking Nier Automata came out since then.
Yeah, that's a good game from what I've seen.
Eventually. Yeah, from what I've seen, it looks pretty good. I don't know if it's a game... I'm not a huge hack and slash person.
It has a lot. It has like 7 different endings. Though, it has, that's cool.
No,
as hell.
It's got way more.
Yeah,
than
it's
that.
Got like 20.
So like 7 main endings.
You can like sell your brain and it counts as an ending.
What the fuck is this game? It's from the fucking Japanese.
Japan. Say no more.
Because, like, you can sell all of your HUD away.
Yeah, like, I know.
Bar.
Even, like, the options menu and shit, right? Mm-hmm. Like, everything.
I really just want to play Hatful Boyfriend still.
Put it on your wish list.
I have already.
Is that not on sale?
Nope, not recently. I've been waiting for it.
So sad.
Hatful Boyfriend.
I want to date
Did
pigeons.
Did it not go on sale? There's like that big fucking
anime sale. I know. It sale. Wasn't there. I looked too.
I was hurt. Huge fucking weeb sale.
That's what it was. My power economics professor said that he got a text from his friend the other day. It was at a conference. And he already had a shitty travel experience, but they rebooked him in a hotel that across the road there was a furry convention, so it was like just filled with a bunch of furries. He was like, I don't want to offend anyone. And it was like, weeb! In the background.
Weeb! I don't want to offend anybody. Fucking weebs!
What's it called? I was trying to tell the guy sitting next to me, I was like, it's a pun on, play on words, it's like, your furry personality. What's that called? It's not like a personality, but it's like, it's something.
Persona.
Persona, that's it. I knew it was something like that. I was like, there's something.
The shit we talk about.
Yeah.
On our channel. So personas.
If you're a furry, be sure to correct the record for us if we mess any of this information up.
Leave your persona in the comments.
Predict our personas for a chance to win.
Like, comment, and subscribe if you have a persona. How the fuck do you get. Oh, it's that
what would,
way.
And I think they talked about this on the official podcast. Can you be a furry but like a scaled animal, like a lizard?
Yeah. Well, yeah, I think that
they're called a lizzie?
I think that applies in the scale of
where's
like,
the skeletons animals. And do I need to break this bridge?
That's so strange.
A lizzie. I don't know what the fuck they're called. Scalies?
That shows you just how overabundance of information and shit you can find if you get so bored with traditional stuff that you just gotta go up to furs.
I feel like I could answer more of these questions if I spend more time on DeviantArt.
Yeah. every time I like get a link to DeviantArt, I'm like, oh, that's nice. Click then, next. It's like, why'd I do that?
No. Fur porn.
Why'd I do that? Every time I try to follow along with demo disc for the Rule 34, because I always want to see the shit that they don't have, that they blur, and I'm like,
oh,
they're going into too much detail. I gotta see it. That's like I need 2 months to cleanse my mind afterwards.
Good old. I don't want that. Well, you know, I think we've covered all the bases today. I
think so.
Unless there's something we haven't covered yet.
And wheat beer is making me where I can't even fucking breathe. So that's good.
Fantastic.
Yeah. I guess that's it. I'll probably have a little quick synopsis thing tomorrow, but. Yeah, that is Dog Pound. That's the channel.
That's the last Dog Pound.
You getting your ass kicked by
everything.
Dogs.
Literally fucking everything. The Dog Pound of the ass. But yeah, so I'd like to say farewell.
Gotta do it an old-fashioned way.
Point to sky.
Where's wave? There you go.
Thanks,
until next time, perhaps.
Perhaps. Goodbye. He's back. Motherfucker.
Back again.
Alright, peace out. Bye.